Dear students, in this lecture we will study about black body radiation. Radiation is a process of propagation of heat from one place to another place without requiring any material medium. As we discussed in the previous chapter, it travels in the vacuum also. All bodies above 0 Kelvin emit thermal radiation continuously. This is as shown in this graph. This graph represents the black body spectrum. Black body means a body which emits all the radiations of all the wavelengths when it is heated. Or otherwise, we can say it can absorb all the wavelengths whenever the radiation of all wavelengths falls on it. This is called as perfect black body. Here, I have taken three examples and they are sun, fire, earth. At 300 Kelvin, Earth emits radiation in this way and it is continuous. It starts from certain wavelength range and it goes on increasing. That means intensity of that radiation goes on increasing and it takes some peak value. After that, it again decreases. For example, for a fire, we can see it a bit clearer. It starts from here and it goes on increasing. Intensity of emitted light or radiation goes on increasing and it reaches some peak value. After that, it decreases. We can see that even clear in the case of sun. That is, it starts from radiating and its intensity goes on increasing up to its surface temperature around 6000 Kelvin. After reaching its surface temperature, it decreases and it decreases continuously as like this. Therefore, we can say light emission or emission of radiation is related to the temperature of an object, with all molecules, atoms and subatomic particles involved in the thermal motion. Let us look at some of features of this black body spectrum. For a given temperature, this energy density emitted or intensity versus wavelength lambda is continuous graph. The intensity of all wavelengths are not same. That means the intensity at all wavelengths, it is not same, it is continuously varying. The intensity rises first and reaches some peak value at certain wavelength lambda m, called this is the wavelength whenever the intensity is maximum. That is, for certain wavelength we represent it as lambda m, and it decreases again. Also, if the temperature of the black body is increased, the intensity increases for all wavelengths, but the maximum shifts towards the lower wavelength side. Look at this picture. If the temperature of the black body is increased, that means if we have different temperatures, so for example, for Earth, if we take it is T1, for fire T2, and for sun T3, such that T3 is greater than T2, T2 is greater than T1. That means they are in increasing order. We have a different intensity pattern. That means they look like same, but the intensity difference is there. Whenever we clearly look at this, the peak of the maximum intensity shift towards the minimum wavelength range. This black body spectrum is obtained from the experiment. Many scientists have tried to explain this theoretically. Some of them are Wien, Rayleigh, Jeans, and they have used many classical ideas to explain this black body spectrum. First one is Wien's displacement law. It states that maximum wavelength at which a black body emits electromagnetic radiation is inversely proportional to the absolute temperature of an object. As we discussed previously, that is, temperature of the black body is inversely proportional to the wavelength corresponding to maximum intensity for a particular black body. That is, lambda m is inversely proportional to T. If we solve this, we will get lambda maximum into t is equal to some constant, where lambda m is the wavelength of maximum emission of the object, it is in meters, temperature of the object is in kelvins. In this formula, you have to look at this entities, here k represents kelvin, m represents meters, kelvin meters. For example, for sun, lambda maximum is nearly equal to 500 nanometers, which corresponds to temperature 5800 Kelvin. It is the surface temperature of sun. And if we take our own body, human body, at 37 degrees Celsius, or it is equal to 310 Kelvins, the maximum wavelength obtained is nearly equal to 9350 nanometers. Now we will look at the physical significance of the Wien's displacement law. Wien's displacement law is successfully explained this black body spectrum in the lower wavelength region, that is wavelengths below the lambda maximum value, and it is failed to explain the longer wavelength region of the black body spectrum. This is the main drawback of the Wien's displacement law. That means Wien did not explain blackbody spectrum completely. Now let us look at what Rayleigh and Jeans have done on explaining blackbody spectrum completely. Rayleigh and Jeans used classical physics to explain the blackbody spectrum by assuming that the law of equipartition of energy is applicable to radiation as well. They showed that energy density U lambda is proportional to 1 divided by lambda to the power 4, where K is Boltzmann constant, T is temperature of the black body. This formula is called as Rayleigh-Jeans formula for black body radiation. Rayleigh-Jeans have successfully explained the longer wavelength region of the black body spectrum, and they fail to explain the lower wavelength region of the black body spectrum, which is called as ultraviolet catastrophe. This discrepancy between theory and experiment for shorter wavelengths is called as ultraviolet catastrophe. Therefore, Rayleigh and Jeans also fail to explain black body spectrum completely. Both of these laws have used classical physics in order to explain black body spectrum. That means classical physics has failed to explain the black body spectrum. Now let us look at the Stefan's law, or Stefan-Boltzmann law. It states that black body emits electromagnetic radiation with a total energy E proportional to the fourth power of the absolute temperature of an object. That is, E is equal to sigma T to the power 4, where sigma is equal to some constant, it is called as, and it is equal to 5.67 to 10 power minus 8 watt per meter square per Kelvin to the power 4, and T is the temperature in Kelvins. This is called as Stefan's law. Stefan's law relates energy emitted by a black body to temperature of the black body, and that is E is proportional to T power 4. Now we will look at the theoretical idea of Max Planck, who completely explained black body spectrum using quantum ideas. The failure of both Wien and Rayleigh-Jeans laws to explain the observed energy distribution law of black body radiation showed that there was something wrong either with the equipartition law of energy or with the classical electromagnetic theory or with both. In 1900, Max Planck developed a structural model for black body radiation that leads to theoretical equation for the wavelength distribution that is in completely agreement with the experimental results at all wavelengths. Planck assumed that oscillators exist at the surface of the black body related to the charges within the molecules. He postulated some of the features which are explained now onwards. The black body is made up of a large number of oscillating particles. These particles can vibrate in all possible frequencies. The frequency of radiation from the body is the same as that of vibrating particles. An oscillator can have a discrete set of energies, which are integral multiples of a finite quantum of energy. That finite quantum of energy is called as quanta. Einstein refined this quantum hypothesis and gave the name photon to the quantum of light energy. Photon represents minimum energy unit of light. It is localized in small volume of space and remains localized as it moves away from the light source. That means energy of photon is equal to E is equal to h nu, where E is energy of photon, h is Planck's constant, nu is frequency of the vibrating photon. Light energy emitted by a source must be integral multiple of photon energy. This is, as I mentioned earlier, rho of nu, energy density, is equal to n h nu, that is n is equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. That means n is a positive integer, h is Planck's constant, nu is frequency of the oscillating particles. The atomic oscillators emit or absorb energy in discrete units. They emit or absorb these energy units by making a transition from one quantum state to another. The amount of radiant energy in each unit is called quantum of energy. Each quantum carries an energy, E is equal to h nu. An oscillator radiates or absorbs energy only when it changes quantum states. If it remains in one quantum state, no energy is absorbed or emitted. I will discuss about quantum states bit later. Now look at the Planck's radiation law. This law governs the intensity of radiation emitted by unit surface area into a fixed direction from the black body as a function of wavelength for a fixed temperature. The energy density in terms of frequency is written as this: rho of nu is equal to 8 pi h nu cube by c cube into 1 divided by e power h nu by kt minus 1. Or in terms of wavelength, rho of lambda is equal to 8 pi hc divided by lambda power 5 into 1 divided by e power hc by lambda kt minus 1. This law completely explained black body spectrum using previously said is hypothesis. Black body radiation spectrum bagge summarize maadbeku anta andre, Wien's law en heltu, lambda m into t is equal to constant anta heltu. That means lambda m is inversely proportional to temperature. Andre temperature naavu jaasti maadidre lambda m kadame irutade, ಅಥವಾ ಟೆಂಪ್ರೇಚರ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಲ್ಯಾಮ್ಡಾ ಎಮ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ. ಈ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ ಅಂದರೆ, ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಇದು ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈ ಆಗೋವಂಥದ್ದು ಲೋವರ್ ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ರೀಜನ್ಗೆ ಮಾತ್ರ. ಇದು ವೇನ್ಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಲ ಪ್ರಕಾರ. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ರ್ಯಾಲೇ ಜೀನ್ಸ್ಲ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇನು, ಅದೇ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಬ್ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ ಬಾಡಿ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ರಮ್ನ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡಿದರು. ಬಟ್ ಅದು ಬರೀ ಲಾಂಗರ್ ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ರೀಜನ್ಗೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈ ಆಯಿತು. ಲಾಂಗರ್ ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ರೀಜನ್ ಅಂತ ಅಂದರೆ ಈ ಸೈಡ್, ಈ ಲಾಂಗರ್ ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ರೀಜನಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತ್ರ ರ್ಯಾಲಿ ಜೀನ್ಸ್ಲ ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈ ಆಯಿತು. ಆ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನೇಟ್ ಆಗಿತ್ತು ಅಂದರೆ 1 ÷ λ⁴, ಅದರ ಮೇಲೆ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಆಗಿತ್ತು ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ. ಅಂದರೆ ವೇನ್ಸ್ಲ ಲೋವರ್ ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ರೀಜನ್ನ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತು ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಆಗಿ, ರ್ಯಾಲಿ ಜೀನ್ಸ್ಲ ಲಾಂಗರ್ ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ರೀಜನ್ನ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ಫುಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ. ಆದರೆ ಎರಡೂ ಲಾಗಳು ಅದನ್ನು ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟಾಗಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಗಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಅವರು ಹಳೆ ಥಿಯರಿಗಳನ್ನ, ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಕಲ್ ಥಿಯರಿಗಳನ್ನ ಬಳಸ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರು. ಅಂದರೆ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಎಮಿಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಅಂದ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರು. ಆ ರೂಲ್ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಅದು ಏನಾಗಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಗಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಹಂಗಾಗಿ ಪ್ಲಾಂಕ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಅಂತ ಅಂದರೆ, ಅವರು ಈ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರೀಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. ನೇಚರಲ್ಲಿ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗಿರಲೇಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಏನಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಈ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರೀಟ್ನೆಸ್ಗೆ ಏನು ಹೇಳಬೇಕು, ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರೀಟ್ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಹೇಳೋದು ಅಂತ ಅಂದರೆ, ಈಗ ಒಂದು ಟ್ಯಾಪಲ್ಲಿ ವಾಟರ್ ಬರ್ತಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ನೀರು ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗಿ ತುಂಬ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಅದನ್ನು ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಅದೇ ಟ್ಯಾಪ್ನ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹನಿ ಹನಿ ಥರ ಬೀಳಂಗೆ ನಿಲ್ಲಿಸಿದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಹನಿ ಹನಿ ಬೀಳ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಆ ರೀತಿಯೇ ಅದನ್ನು ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರೀಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿಬೋದು. ಆ ಪ್ಯಾಕೆಟ್ ಪ್ಯಾಕೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟ ಅಂತ ಏನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ವಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಹನಿಗಳು ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಅನ್ಕೋಬೋದು. ಒಂದೊಂದೇ ಹನಿ ಬೀಳ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಆ ಥರ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆ ರೀತಿ ಎಮಿಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಎಮಿಟ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಪ್ಲಾಂಕ್ ಬಹುಮುಖ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಪ್ರತಿಪಾದನೆ ಮಾಡಿದಂತಹದ್ದು. ಅದನ್ನು ಬಳಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅವರು ಥಿಯರಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದೇ ಈ ಪ್ಲಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್ ಲಾ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಈ ಪ್ಲಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್ ಲಾ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಬ್ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ರಮ್ನ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಐನ್ಸ್ಟೀನ್ ಅವರ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಕೂಡ ತುಂಬ ಮುಖ್ಯವಾಗಿದೆ. ಅದೇನು ನಾನು ಇಂಟಗ್ರಲ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಾ ಅಂತ ಏನು ಹೇಳಿದೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಐನ್ಸ್ಟೀನ್ ಅವರು ಪ್ರಿಡಿಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು, ಅದನ್ನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಅವರು ಕೂಡ ಪ್ಲಾಂಕ್ಸ್ನ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿರೈವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ.